Paul Falavolito podcasts are available on iTunes, Google Play Music, and your favorite podcasting platforms. Be sure and download and listen to each episode and share them throughout your social media. Leave comments, inquire about sponsoring a show, and get your feedback on the air by visiting paulfalavolitopodcast.com.
Broadcasting from the Steel City, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, a podcast unlike any other. A podcast that will revolutionize absolutely nothing.
It's motivating. It's enlightening. It's banter like you've never heard before.
It's magical, sprinkled with a huge dash of awesome. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Get settled in.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your host, Paul Falavolito.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast. This is episode 41, and the title of today's show is Lessons Learned from Clint Hurdle. And that's right, I said Clint Hurdle. And for those of you listening to this that may not know who Clint Hurdle is, the 39th manager of the Pittsburgh Pirates, Major League Baseball team. And a few weeks ago, I had the crazy, awesome privilege of being able to attend the Clint Hurdle leadership talk down at PNC Park before a game. And he had with him Rod Olson. And Rod Olson is an award-winning motivational speaker and author. And this guy is kind of like a coach to the coaches in baseball. And he's written a bunch of books, and they're amazing, and they gave us all a copy. This guy's talked to like Navy SEAL commanders, Fortune 500 CEOs of just major, major companies. He's just the real deal when it comes to motivational speaking. And together, the two of them delivered an amazing leadership talk. And I have a million notes here. And so I want to break this up into a bunch of different segments. So this is going to be Lessons Learned from Clint Hurdle, Part 1. And the first bullet point that I want to talk to you about is when Clint Hurdle talked about fighting for balance in your life every day. And again, this speaks to being aware of professional responsibility and your personal responsibilities. You may see people every day that have great traits and they've done great things and they have an amazing trophy wall and a million plaques on their wall and a great resume. And if you ever get a chance to peek behind the curtain and meet their family or go to their home, and you kind of stand there and you're like, wow, they're completely disconnected. And it's true that we can get so engaged in saving the world that we lose our home or we lose our relationship. And we can get so engaged trying to resurrect a business that our kids aren't paid enough attention to. And one of the things I thought was really special from this discussion was when Clint Hurdle shared with everybody a personal story. And that is that they have resolutions at their home. They don't have rules in the Hurdle household. They have resolutions. And his wife kind of invented this concept, he said, and I thought this was brilliant. And she told him that you have 5 minutes every day to unload when you get home. And that if you have any rocks in your shoes from the day at work or the day became problematic or you had a situation with a tough player, or again in today's business world, that could be if you had a situation with an employee or HR and it was chafing at you all day, you get 5 minutes to be concise and get rid of it when you get home. Be factual. Don't get caught up in the story because you love to hear yourself talk, which we can often do when we tell stories. And he said that a physical timer will actually go off. And so he's had to learn how to prioritize cleaning the slate when he gets home. And he said some days it takes him 5 minutes, some days it takes him 3. But the great take-home point from this was that pouring into your family can give you great feedback from someone that's not connected to your job. And I thought that was really special to hear him share that much of a personal story with everyone that was there. But it was this one that really kind of woke me up even more than I already was. And that was the saying, be where your feet are. Be where your feet are. And I know that sounds cute and it's fluffy and it's kind of, you know, just one of those little cute catchphrases in modern day. But think about that for a second. How many of us actually do it? Like right now, you're here, you're listening to this podcast, but are you looking at your phone? Are you wondering what you're doing later? Do you have another Google screen open looking for movie times or other podcasts to listen to? But are you really where your feet are? And as leaders and managers, we have to stop and we have to take that concept of being where your feet are and apply that to today's business world. Walk around your office and look at how many of your employees are truly where their feet are. We live in that crazy cell phone, social media, you know, fast-paced world of people walking around not looking where they're going with their phones up to their faces. It's a struggle. I see it every day. And when I go out every day, it doesn't matter if I'm going shopping or going out to eat. I study businesses. I study business models. I study different employee behaviors. And it's absolutely true. Up until I heard Clint Hurdle say, be where your feet are, I just always thought to myself, wow, it's crazy that so many people are on their cell phones and they're just so disengaged. And so to me, that was the great take-home point from that. Be where your feet are. And this last one, where I'll cut this episode, is talking about balance in life and why it's so important to have balance, because obviously without balance, you're tilted. When you're at work, you need to be at work. When you're at home, you need to be home. Think about this one for a second here, because this one's totally made me think differently. Many times employees bring stuff to work with their pockets. Their pockets are full of their problems and their issues. And we always used to have that hardcore policy that said, leave the drama at the door. But think about this for a second. Some of the best conversations and the most important conversations you have to have with your people may be about something else that's not job-related, which can alleviate the weight or lift the burden that frees your people up to perform their jobs better. We have to do it because at the end of the day, we also have to realize that our people have to empty the rocks from their pocket too. So, Clint Hurdle, lessons learned from Clint Hurdle, episode 1. I promise you, the next couple episodes, I'm going to keep dissecting the notes from this talk. And I'm going to deliver all the important ones to you. It was truly amazing. These are little tidbits of info that you can absolutely deploy right into your daily routine and help you. I've already seen improvements from the little pieces of information I gathered from this and by dropping them into my company. I hope they'll help you and benefit you too. As for now, this is episode 41 of the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, and I thank you for listening.
You're listening to the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast presented by Paul Falavolito.